You deposit $1,500 into a bank that pays 4% continuous interest. It's important that we pay close attention to the type of interest because there are different formulas for compounded interest and continuous interest. The continuous interest formula is A equals P times E raised to the power of RT, where P is the principal or starting amount in the account, R is the annual interest rate expressed as a decimal, T is the time in years, and A is the amount after T years. So the formula for continuous interest is actually less involved than the formula for compounded interest. So for this situation, we would have A equals P, the starting amount, $1,500, times E raised to the power of R times T. Again, R is the annual interest rate expressed as a decimal. 4% as a decimal would be 0.04 times T in years. We don't know T, so it stays a variable. So this would be the equation that would determine the account balance after T years. So if we want to know the account balance after 2 years, we can determine A of 2, or substitute 2 for T. So we'd have 1,500 times E raised to the power of 0.04 times 2. Now we'll go to the calculator and determine this value. If we press second natural log, it brings up E raised to the power of, we just type in 0.04 times 2, close parenthesis, and the account balance would be approximately $1,624.93. To find the account balance after 10 years, we just substitute 10 for T. So A of 10 would be equal to 1,500 times E raised to the power of 0.04 times 10. So we can go back to the calculator and determine this value. So now the account balance would be $2,237 and approximately 74 cents. Okay, in the next video, we'll take a look at determining how long it will take for an account like this to reach a specific balance.